Thank you very much for coming to Padua, for giving your talk yesterday. It was really nice. Now, I would like to ask you, what is the focus of your researches in this period?
And thank you very much for inviting me and allowing me to be a part of this project. I am a historian of science working in Istanbul Medeniyet University in Istanbul, Turkey. And I work on specifically astronomical and more generally scientific instruments in the Islamic world between 10th and 16th centuries. What I work on specifically, astronomical instruments made for timekeeping, and how I process this project is I read the manuscripts, I learn about how to make the instruments, and I try to physically make it as they were explained in the book, or when there is a original instrument in a museum, I try to replicate the same thing and use it into my research, understanding how they were using, how accurate they were, and use those all information in my teachings. I also work with University of Oxford as a research associate for a project about a 17th century astronomer named John Greaves, who learned Arabic, Persian, and Ottoman Turkish and visited Islamic lands, made observations, and used those information from the Islamic world to create his own calendar. And I'm trying to trace back his information, trying to create some sort of a timeline with a project team, of course.
So Taha, you are part of this project, this third mission project of the Department of Physics and Astronomy. At end of February, you will come back to have workshops with our working groups. What do you think of the project?
I think it's a very important initiative, and I am happy to be a part of this. And when we think about science in the Islamic world, and they usually remain hidden from the Western sources, or at least in the modern times, very few people know about them. And explaining them in a little bit better for general public, creating a public engagement with science in the Islamic world, is a crucial topic that we needed to address for a long time. And this is a very good start for us, specifically in Italy. And being part of this, as a practicing Muslim myself, working on science in the Islamic world, I am hoping this will give a little bit of different perspective to the communities that who may not actually have any kind of broader understanding of the science in the Islamic world written by Western sources, but now they will be able to understand that they were accurate in many ways, and we are actually trying to establish new links with the modernity and modern sciences, with what we have achieved in the Islamic world in the medieval times. And this workshop will be very important because what we want to do is trying to use the material they were using to calculate time, like astrolabes that you can see behind me. And we'll try to make a sense of how they were planning to use scientific material to create understanding for themselves. And many people who join our workshops will be able to do this by themselves with the help of experts in this area.